Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're in Northern California on the Feather River using artificial lures for striped bass. Now if you all learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television.
All right, we're out here on the Feather River this morning. It's 3:30 in the morning. We've got a special spot we want to fish, so we're gonna get here early. We left it last night about 10 o'clock. A lot of bass out here. They've been spawning last 2 days and the bite's getting a little tougher, so they always do this. They'll the first big spawn of the year, and then they just seem like they all disappear. And then they come back, they'll reappear within a week or so. We got cold weather today, this morning, so that's gonna help a lot. And on the screen here, on my Lowrance, there's all the fish you want, so hopefully they'll bite this morning. Welcome to the jungle, boys. Just hang on before we start casting. We got a tie-off, Pat. This spot, you don't want to float. We're going to go into the bank, and we're going to tie off the boat to the bank, and we're going to cast out what we have. Real shallow hard pan, and it's coming over the hard pan and dumping into deep water. And the fish come up out of that deep water, and they come up and they feed on that bait. If they're in this spot, they're only there for one reason. That's to eat. And then tie off right there, nice and snug. You can wrap it around it and come back to that cleat, pull it real tight. The water's dropping fast, and I wish the temperature would drop in the water, because what's going on when they start spawning, you know, they'll break up the big school. Right now, they're all together. If we could get the water temp to drop a little, then we would have the fish just stuck in one spot, and we'll be able to tee off on them, and just stay on them, and they'll keep biting and feeding. But they're gonna spawn, and once they're done spawning, they're gonna spread out, go every direction. Then you gotta go back to pocket fishing, fish for one here, one there. But right now we got these huge schools, and that normally lasts about a week, and then they'll blow up, and we're at the tail end of it. But there's still plenty of fish grouped up. I expect to find some big groups today, like we've seen on the screen a second ago, so hopefully they'll be biting. Beautiful right there, Dalton, nice and close. I know my fish are here, and I haven't been able to get a bite yet, so I'm going with the oil. Most time we use gel, but I like the oil. Darn braided line. I got P-line 50 pound braided line. I tie it direct. Use a big hook, big strong heavy hook. But with this line, you can feel, you really can feel anything. We used to use mono, and you had to have a real light sensitive rod and a short rod. Shorter back then, 6'6" rod. Because you would feel the bite on the worm is real key to feel the bite on the worm. Well, we went to this braid, this 50 pound P-line braid, and it's worked out really well. You can get away with not such a sensitive small rod, and you'll feel the lightest of taps, because when you're worm fishing, it's just a light tap. First bass of the day.
Ooh, that was lucky. You see that pop right out?
Black worm. Yeah, you shouldn't put your hand in his gills like that because you kill it. Nice bass though. It's right where he's supposed to be, right where we thought. It's like shallow, a little drop off, and then boom. Another one, Dalton?
Yep.
Right on. They're moving in. Ooh, a lot better fish. Need the net? Nice bass. We're gonna keep a couple to keep. That's a good one if you wanna keep it going.
That was a perfect size eater fish, a male, about 7-8 pounds. You know, we let our big males go and our females go. They're just, you know, they've been out in the bay and all that. Who knows what they have out there. The smaller fish are your better eaten fish by far. The meat gets a little stringier. It changes when they get, you know, the bigger fish, the 12, 14, 15 pound on up. I don't keep anything over 15 pounds.
Welcome back to the Feather River. I'm Justin Wolf. We're with Raith Heryford, who's fishing with his nephew Dalton Heryford and his friend Pat Haas. And it's a good thing they're here because Raith's not catching anything.
I haven't caught nothing. I haven't even got a bite. I'm getting schooled, so I'm going to my old secret weapon here. Oh, baby. Come on, baby. I haven't had a bite. Not on a worm. Not on, they're catching them in front of me. They're catching them behind me. Last night, same thing. I couldn't get bit, but that's okay as long as everybody else is catching them. Like, sooner or later, if you're in a slump, you're going to get out of the slump by just keep casting, keep doing what you know is right, and you'll catch a fish. So I'll catch a fish sooner or later, but I'm way behind.
Moving in. Good old pro cure right here. Best stuff there is. That's the unmarked one. I guess that's the good one. Secret one. Put a little bit on here, rub it on, and that's the ticket.
Hand me that bottle of stuff. My label went off.
Hit my tail off.
He got it. His lucky lure got bit in half. He put the sauce on, but my label came off. He was riding in the boat, and I was washing the boat out and getting it wet and rubbing on everything. I wore the label off, but it's anchovy gel, if you want to know.
You got a fish? Fish on.
Okay, I got a measuring thing here. It's at 20 inches, and so I just tail goes on the corner. Okay, it's past it. It's about a 21 inch, 20 and a half inch fish. That's kind of my limit. I like them. They're a little thicker, but perfect eating fish. Easy to clean, all that. So we bleed them. We'll put them live well. Then we'll finish cleaning them up later. But great. Great eating fish right there, perfect. Really bad on the salmon, these ones. These little guys are the ones that tear up our little salmon smolt. The bigger ones kind of leave them alone, but that one right there is an eater. Okay, we're throwing artificial. There's a boat out here using minnows. He's got about 5 rods with live minnows on, but man, they are just, you know, it's almost $2 a minnow now, and they're literally catching fish not much bigger than a minnow. And so to get away from the smaller fish and that with the artificial, we seem to catch a little better fish. And if you do catch a small fish, just let it go because, you know, it's not costing you anything. You can use the same lure all day. But for cost efficiency and you get a little better quality, I think artificial is the way to go. There's plenty of fish. You're going to catch all you want. If you want to catch 100 fish, put on live bait, drop them down there and weed through them, and you'll get nice fish. And once in a while they get a great big one, but you get a big lazy fish and put that little minnow in front of his face. But yeah, that's what's going on. So we got live bait, then we got artificial. Oh, there he is. It was just popping. You gotta just hop that lure along, hopping along. They're barely biting today because of the spawn. So you gotta really pop, pop, pop. They'll grab it 2 or 3 times before you actually hook them. Not a monster, but a nice bass.
Well, it feels a little bit better.
Okay, we got some fish here. We did really well. We had a nice morning right here. Caught plenty of fish, probably 20 fish. Dalton caught most of them. We're gonna go trolling now. We got P-line, predators. It's deep water down here where we're at, bunch of fish in here. We're gonna tip them with the worm tail and some broke gear, of course. And we should do really well. Should catch a lot of fish, maybe some big fish. So we're gonna make a few more casts. Wrap this up right here. Caught plenty of fish, great action. Spent a couple hours here this morning, started in the dark, all the boats showed up, all that. Still getting bites, but now we're gonna go try to get some bigger fish. The big fish weren't here this morning. We'll move down and get in some deeper water and troll the predators, and then maybe an angry eye if we get on some shallow water fishing. But probably we're gonna stick with the predators today. Deeper water, run about 12, 14 feet deep, and tip them with the white worm and add a little sauce to them, broke here. And anyways, we'll get back to you and get some big fish.
We're on the Feather River near Yuba City, California.
There he is.
Having good luck using artificial lures. So far we've been casting plastics, but now it's time to switch to trolling hard baits.
It was the last cast for this place. And pretty good fish. We're here. That's lots of dinky ones. We just can't, we're not any size, and once again, it's in the bottom lip. That hook's right in the bottom lip, so we're gonna go trolling. We're gonna go try for some bigger fish. We're gonna put on the predator and go trolling. We're just heading downstream now. We're gonna go on some of my trolling spots that I like to troll. 2017 striper season, if you look around, there's people everywhere. We've caught a bunch of fish. Smile, guys. It's pretty insane. All the local guys, all your old high school friends and all that, everybody's out here getting some of these fish. So it's a great year, a lot of water, a lot of fish, amazing fishery. Unbelievable. We're gonna go down here and we're gonna put on these trolling lures now. That's the predator, it's a trout pattern. Tip it with the white worm, put a little pro cure on. I'm looking for 12 to 16 feet of water. I don't want real deep water.
Just right here, you take this back hook. You want this part laying flat right here, and you got two up here on the top and then one down here on the bottom. It's the one you wanna put your worm on. All we're doing here is just put it through a little bit, tip it, pull it through and run it up so it's straight on there. If you don't have it on the right hook, it's gonna swim sideways, get all out of whack, and end up tangling your lines up. It's right there.
Fish on, fish on, just like that. There it is. There it is. See the rod doing the work? It's got a big bend to it. We didn't go 10 feet. But it is my home water, and I know where I like to troll. Doesn't feel like a monster, but if you look at that rod, it's really bent. It's a nice keeper bass. I mean, it's got a one, it only has one hook in its mouth, but the rod did its job. The rod bent down and let the fish get a hold of them hooks, and we were able to land that fish. And these fish are not wanting to really bite today, but the rod did its job. That's a release you want, because it's really hard to play with all these hooks without something bad happening. But you know, that's a great color. It's always been a great color lure. P-Line has really stepped up their game with their lures. Cousins come out with the trolling rod. It's got a real soft tip, it's got a heavy backbone. It's good for when the fish grab a hold of all them hooks. When they grab them, what happens is the fish starts twirling and spinning. And if you have a stiff rod, it's just gonna pull all the hooks out. It gives it time to wrap up in all the hooks and really get hooked well. You land a lot more fish with the softer tip, and they made it strictly for trolling.
There he is.
is.
Nope. Not a big fish. But the water's so fast and the bite is so violent that that's how you bend hooks and everything else, man. But
boy.
Smart fish trying to get me in the trees. Try to keep your tips down low, keep them under the water. Nice fish. So when you're using trolling, if you got plenty of fish, we've got plenty of fish. It's great eater. We're gonna eat this fish if we get it in, but we've got plenty, so we're not worried about if we lose it or not. If you don't want to break your monofilament net, you grab your lure right here, up and over, real quick. Just grab the tip of the lure, then you can be in control. Then you can lay it on your floor and then work on it. But that way, if you put that lure in the net, there's no way to break a lure faster than put it in the net. You'll ruin the hooks. You'll change the way your lure's running. Your lures are running straight. If you put it in the net, it's going to bend all your eye rings and everything and turn them. After you catch every fish, you need to check all your hook eye rings and that. Don't blame the lure. You got to do your job too. They come out working real well. And then once you put it in the net and that, you can change the action of your whole lure. You won't catch any more fish on that lure. So it's easy just to grab your leader and put them in the boat that way. If you have to put it in the net, go ahead and put it in the net, or a boga grip works real well also. So we're going to take this one off and box this fish. These lures are on fire.
Welcome back to the Feather River, where the feline predator is on fire.
That was the hot lure right here, but the water's clearing up, so this one's been, this is a neat lure, man. They're just killing it, so we're gonna let Pat have this one, old Lucky Pat. Pat, what do you think? Look good?
Heck yeah. Okay. About time. I get a good lure.
There he is. Yeah, we stopped the motor on the reel end. He was reeling in, came around that point, boom. It happens often. Bring it right around that side, Pat, right where you're at. There you go.
What?
Pat's known to lose them. He's known.
Shut
up. He's known to lose the big ones. He's known to lose them. He's trying to make. Oh yeah, there he is. Woo! Look at that one. It's a 15 pounder. Let me get the poker grip. He made up for last year. Pat made up for last year. He had a big one last year. There's a big hen. Right over here. Let's get a weight on it. Give me some line.
Let me take us out a little bit.
Yeah, go ahead. Just like I said, 15 pounds. Nice fish.
Ready?
Wait. Reel a man, get a man, take your picture, let him go. She's in good shape. She'll have a lot of babies for us. There's some big fish in her. I had a big one, and Pat got the big one. Last year, he lost the big one, and he made up for it this year. Good job, it was awesome. There's a lot bigger than that though. We're gonna go 30, 40, 50 pound. Robert Byers caught one 60 pounds here on 15 pound, I think it was 12 pound line years ago, right here in the same place. But this is a big fish area, Shanghai Bend, Feather River, always known for big fish. That's a nice fish, but we're gonna go for a real big one. This lure is probably the number one go-to lure out of any lure there is, but the trout has been hot. The water cleared up. That trout one, it's just been a hot lure. But the green and redhead in the dirty water I go to, but this one right now is pretty hard to beat.
Putting a little anchovy procure on here. It's been working all day. Had it on our worms earlier. Now we're tipping our plugs with it, with the worm. Add a little anchovy on there. It seems to be really helping. The last two fish have both come off it. It's been good today.
Oh, I'm so glad for you, Pat, that that one stuck. Fish?
Yep.
Big one, huh? Fish or log?
That's a fish. Oh yeah, good fish.
Another big one. Woo! Another big one. Whoa, look at that one. Whoa, look at that one. There's a 20 pounder. 20 pounder. Twenty-pound fish right there, folks. Good fish, big fish today. Easy, Dalton. Okay, give me line.
Okay, see you.
Ready?
Yep. Oh. There we go.
Not quite 20, but it's a big fish. Look at that. They always look bigger in the water. Another 15-pounder.
We'll take it though.
Yeah, this fish is too big, so we want to release this one. We don't keep nothing real big. This is past my limit. I like them. I like them like we had earlier, 5 pounds. Big fish, here we go. Yeah. Oh!
Got him.
Look at that rod do all the work. Oh, that was nice. I still get excited. I mean, after all this time, all these fish we've caught, I mean, that bite, it's just great. That big old long rod, look at it go.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.